everyone, welcome back to the second video in my Melody marathon or something. Yeah, the in and out of love melody, let's make it Headhunters today. Yeah, so this is what we've got right now. Now, I can promise you one thing, at the end of this video, it will totally sound different. So, yeah. Now, let's first replace this one with silent one. Because that will give us more the feeling of a lead sound. Okay, now let's open up the mono legato, the portamento right here. And let's make it mono legato. Keep it on the N from, yeah, I'm not sure, normal, I guess. Yeah, something like this. Now we can do some pitch bending. Okay, so first I'm going to try some things to connect with this melody. Okay, let's do this. Yeah. So basically, this is the note. I'm placing a smaller note underneath it, perhaps even this short, and then holding shift and scrolling down one click. And there it goes. This is the effect. Okay, let's do that with every beginning note. Okay, and let's do the same thing here with a higher note. Okay, that sucks. Okay, let's do the same thing. Don't do this too frequently because it will start to sound boring again. Okay, let's try this. Okay, cool. So I'm creating this note right here. This one is D. It's a D. So let's click a D lower. This is a D8. What? D6. And this is a D5. So at the end of this note, it travels down a little. Yeah, it gives this pitch bend effect. Let's do that with all the second long notes. This is an A. So let's do another A. If you take another note, the lower you go, the harder it will travel down. And the higher you go, the less difference you will hear. This has also a lot to do with your portamento legato settings, but yeah. Okay, right here, nothing happens. Let's fix that. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, that's nice. Okay, let's do again one here. It's starting to sound like a Tweaker's duck sound. Wow. Okay, something like this. Yeah, it's basically having fun with monologato, with the pitch bending. You can do crazy things with that. Really in silence, you can do lots of crazy things with the pitch bend. When I play some notes here, just hear this. Now you can create your own vibrato effects. Yeah, but for that the legato has to be lower or less. Now, this is our first lead. Let's make it lead one. Yeah. Let's give it a personal name. Let's make this, square lead. Now, let's do some other things before we clone it and reuse it. Let's add pitch A and B right here. It's going to pitch A and B with an envelope. So, opening up decay a little and sustain going down. Now, we will hear no difference. That's because we have to wobble this knob right here. So when I go to the left, the pitch will bend from low to high when the note starts playing. And when I'm going to the right, you will hear some sort of chop high pitch sound. So the pitch will go from high to low. Now this is of course way too extreme. Let's go for down to up. Okay, something like this. Now it's ready. Let's clone it up. Let's make this the saw lead. Saw lead. So now this is the Headhunter style lead. His new track he did in the not Destiny but before that with the square lead, not the one in the intro of his vlog, the vlog switch style or something, but the other one, that really inspired me to design this lead. And it's always my own preset, and I always create new presets, new sounds. I never use existing ones. Goddamn English. Okay, so let's create my square lead. And for that we of course need a square lead. So let's give it a square lead. Now on part B is a square lead with one voice. Retreat can be left on because there's only one voice. That's not really a big difference. Let's go to part A. Let's grab a saw. And let's go one octave up. When we play those two together, it sounds really aggressive. Now, this is the new silent. For this, I prefer the old silent because it was less pure, less clear sounding. So yeah, this preset sounded a lot better. But then the new one does its job also. Let's grab this wave, the random wave, rate all the way up, gain opening a little bit, pitch A, and drag this one down. Now it's not a really clear sound saw wave anymore. It's now a little bit messy, noisy. Let's go to part B. Let's do the same thing with pitch B. Now let's go up and grab the Lorenz. I don't know why anymore, but yeah, it makes it sound a little more analog somehow. Yeah, so that's about it. Those two together sound like this. Yeah, it's a terrible sound, but then when we click on the distortion button and don't change any settings, it will sound like my Headhunter's style square lead. And that's basically all there is to it. So that's our first sound. Let's clone the melody, let's go to the saw lead. And let's clone it a few more times. Now let's change some of the. No, let's first create a saw lead itself. 8 voices and detune. Copy this one to the right and let's go 1 octave down. Wait a minute, let's grab a square. Now these two are basically the same presets, but they sound totally different because of the voices and the LFOs and the distortion. It sounds totally different. This one has to be higher. Not that way. And together they sound like this. But they still sound like one sound. So to give it a little bit more interesting stereo effect thingy, let's change the portamento a little bit. Let's make it more aggressive by lowering the portamento. Something like that. Now let's change the pitch AB a little. It doesn't really matter how you change it. Make it a tiny change. And when I play them again together, it will sound different. Perhaps a little too extreme, but that might turn out to be interesting. Now, let's make another sound. This will be the bus lead. And this will be a simple saw with a chorus. Let's change those settings again. Perhaps a little bit lower. Now, let's play those three together again. And this is what the lead sounds right. Sounds like. Okay, nice. So let's do those chords on the background. Okay, insert silent one. We could do this with Serum. It has the same possibilities. But yeah. Let's make it silent. I'm really in the mood for silent. Yeah. Oh, wait. Crap. Now, let's make these chords a little shorter. The thing we're going to do now is make these chords match the melody. So, yeah. Let's do it like this. Simply clone it. And again. And again. And again, and again, and again. And that was very simple. Okay, right here, I forgot something. There are 3 notes. Okay, let's make them match big time. And again. Okay, these are of course very bad chords. So first let's increase the polyphony because it's currently on number 3 and it has to be on 4, but I already like the maximum. So let's go to the maximum. Starting to sound like chords. Yeah, let's give it one more octave. Now let's make those chords a little more interesting. Okay, the reason I'm making some little changes is to make the chords to make them play a role too in the total melody finally. So yeah, so it doesn't really sound boring. Okay, that's nice. Let's make the heady style sound. Yeah. For the chords, I sort of always use the same sound. 8 voices with a saw. Copying it, pasting it, making it 8 voices again with 1 octave up. Can be lower. Sounds perfect to me. We can do this, copying it and pasting it, giving it 2 octaves and lowering the volume a little bit for a little more brightness. Now let's give it a pitch bend. We can make the choice to make it sound aggressive. And let's do that because this sounds fine. Now, removing those FL keys downstairs. And yeah, this is what we have so far. Wait, let's first do the bass line and then move on to the next video. Let's clone it, why not? Let's call this the bass. And let's clone it again and let's call that one the sub, because we are going to do a low cut on the bass and the sub will fill in that low cut. Okay, almost there. Okay. Yeah, that's the bass sound. Simply adding square lead right here and lowering at 1 octave. Yeah, let's change the pitch a little. Okay, something like this. Okay, awesome. Let's clone that one too into the sub. The sub is simply a sinus. Something like this, but it sounds a little bit ticky. You hear some background noise. Let's open up the attack and the release, just 1 click. Now it's fine. So let's first check our volumes and then you will hear the end result for today. Okay, I think the volumes are right. Awesome. Now, thank you all for watching. Next video, we will do some mixing and some other stuff. Again, thank you and goodbye.